Welcome to Stay at Home Connect. I'm Phyllis Jackson.
Moderna says preliminary numbers show its COVID-19 vaccine to be nearly 95% effective. Atlanta's Emory University took part in the first clinical trial, enrolling 700 diverse participants. Dr. Colleen Kelly serves as Associate Professor of Medicine at Emory University School of Medicine and Principal Investigator for the Moderna study at the Ponce de Leon Center. She spoke to concerns associated with how fast the vaccine was created.
No steps in the regular sequence of vaccine development or product development have been skipped. The steps of product development, and in this case, vaccine development, were performed in series as opposed to, or were performed in parallel as opposed to typically they're performed in series. And that is how we so quickly came to these results. We will know the full side effect profile for the 30,000 people that participated in the trial. That will be coming forth, I'm sure, and with that peer review data that we're waiting on. That will help us to communicate to communities and to people the safety of the vaccine.
Dr. Kelly says the real work begins to convince citizens and their family members to get the vaccine. For now, the next step is getting emergency use authorization from the FDA, a process that could take several weeks. The Department of Health and Human Services is working with the state's public health departments to create a deployment plan for the vaccine. Some could be prepared for shipment by the end of the year. COVID-19 is impacting the start of the second semester for students at Morehouse, Spelman, and Clark Atlanta University. The presidents of all three institutions say spring classes will begin February 1st, 2021. Morehouse President David A. Thomas says, quote, "As we look to the spring, we will embrace a new normal," end quote. That new normal will include a reduction of students on campus. The statement goes on to say that by reducing the number of students, each of the schools will be able to implement rigorous health and safety protocols designed to mitigate the spread of the virus. Turkey farmers say the pandemic is hurting demand for Thanksgiving, as many families follow the CDC's advice and reduce the size of gatherings. Smaller turkeys are getting more attention than the larger ones, which means a major financial hit, as the price difference could be as much as $40. If you're planning to connect with loved ones over Zoom this Thanksgiving, you'll have more time to do it. Zoom is lifting its 40-minute limit on free virtual chats, so you can spend more time with friends and family. You'll have from midnight on Thanksgiving Day to 6 a.m. Eastern Time on November 27th. Atlanta City Council member Matt Westmoreland takes part in a panel discussion on Atlanta's housing affordability crisis. You can get a link to NPR Atlanta affiliate WABE's Coffee Conversations with Rose Scott by checking out our Twitter page at ATL Council.
That's a wrap. We'll see you on the next edition of Stay at Home Connect.